Edward Martin Stein, a keen marine enthusiast and a passionate researcher of whales and dolphins, has launched the second edition of his bestseller, Out of the Blue. And we are here to find out what this edition has to offer, as well as to talk to the author and find out what he has to say about it. So stay tuned for a sneak peek. My name is Shalindri and you are with Pulse. Mr. Wade Camel, a very good friend of Mr. Howard, as well as his colleague. Nice to meet you.
Hi, very nice to meet you. This is a great tonight.
Great tonight, I know. The book seems really wonderful. So what are your thoughts about it?
Well, I really like the cover shot. That was a big day that we had out with a gentleman named Patrick Dykster, Howard, and myself. And we got to interact with a whale without using a motorized boat. So we wanted to see basically what that interaction would be like, and it was an incredible day out.
So is that what the book is all about?
No, I think the book is really about trying to, my interpretation, is to give people the incredible facts of the marine life that is in Sri Lanka and how do we protect it and how important it is and how rare it is.
So how long have you known Mr. Howard?
I've known Howard and his family since I arrived here, about 16 years. And the country's going through a big change right now. As tourism develops and grows, these incredible natural gifts of the island, I hope, can be protected as we see development. But it's not easy and they're under risk. It's a lot of risk for them.
Like, so it's really important to protect them, right? So what are the measures that you guys take in your company?
In our company? Well, we do a lot with education. We work with a lot of international school groups. We work with a lot of local school groups. And a big part of every program that we have is about our impact on the environment. How do we sustain it? With young people, the importance of nature. So that's one way that we're able to, I think, affect a positive change. And then there's real smart things like we don't use plastic bottles on our whale watching tours. We use recyclable materials and it's really about making it more than just an experience, but an educational experience, a learning experience.
Have with us Mr. Russell Miranda, who helped with the designing of the book. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing great, yes. So if you could tell us a little bit about yourself and how long have you known Mr. Howard?
I've known Howard now, how do I say this, about 15, 20 years. Yeah. And how I got involved with designing the book was when Howard told me he was doing this. He just wanted some help with designing the look and feel of it. I mean, I have to say, largely, it's his brainchild, even in terms of the structure of the design. But with some of the finer things like selecting typeface and certain layout structures and all that, which is really very interesting, given that I know very little about the subject that he's the expert on. It is really interesting to get immersed into it, and it's a great book in terms of the content and all of that.
So what do you think about the content?
Well, I think it's one of the first books of its kind in terms of the level of the scientific approach he's taken to putting it together. And I don't think anyone has really done such a comprehensive study on the whales and the mammal life in our waters as extensively as this. So it's really a very valuable book.
And this is the dear sister of Mr. Howard, Maeve Martinstein. Very nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you, Shalindri, too.
It must be a great evening for all of you.
Yes, it is, very much. A celebration of my brother Howard's second book, in fact. And his first one was put out 5 years ago, after 5 years of passionate research. and now 5 years later, the second book, it's called Out of the Blue, and it's 1 and 2. What else?
So how long has he been such a passionate marine enthusiast?
Well, as a family, we all are. Since my father's time, we lost him very young, and then my stepfather. And we've all been water babies, so to speak. We all sail, swim, dive, ski, everything in the water. So it's part and parcel of our family life.
So what are your thoughts about marine life? Obviously, they're at risk, so what are your thoughts?
I think we need to protect it. And if that's essential for our environment, and they're beautiful creatures, harmless. And it's a pity to see sometimes that, you know, people abuse the fact that we have so many in our waters. And, I hope someone will do something about the preservation.
And we're really glad to have books such as these, because it will definitely educate people about it, right?
Oh, yes, definitely.
The author of the book himself, Mr. Howard Martinstein. Very nice to meet you, and first and foremost, let me congratulate you.
Thank you. And what's your name?
I'm Shalindri. Yes.
Oh, Shalindri. Lovely to meet you this evening.
Lovely to meet you too. Yes. Seems like a really great book.
Oh, I'm glad you like it. Have you had a look at it?
I did. You couldn't read it properly, but yeah, I will read it before I leave today, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. So if you could tell us a little bit about yourself, and how long have you been a marine enthusiast?
Yeah. Well, you see, it all comes from my childhood. So my family was in the marine world. My father was a pioneer in the business world. And my brother was virtually a legend when it came to naval life and water sports. So it was natural that I would, that this would be my calling one day. And in fact, as I mentioned in my speech, it was my older brother that taught me how to swim by throwing me overboard and saying, "Swim to the other boat." And that's, I never looked back since then.
So what's your book all about? What's the incident behind it?
Yeah, so it's not your standard book on marine mammals. It's education based. And not only does it deal with the marine animals, but it also deals with the environment. And it is very important that you understand the entire environment that these animals live in. Because when you want to seek out any kind of animal at the sea, you have to know how the ocean works.
So what are your thoughts about marine life in Sri Lanka?
Oh, I think marine life is like wildlife. I think it's great. A lot of people don't realize what a wonderful marine life we have around our seas. And this is what actually drew me into this field, because I love the natural world. You know, in my family, we loved the land as well as the ocean. But 15 years ago, I realized for an island nation how little we knew about the ocean. So this was very important then for me to spend my time to educate people on the ocean around us and what we have, and bring everything back out to life.